Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about dislocation of hip. Hip dislocation is disruption of joint between femur and pelvis. It is of two types, posterior hip dislocation and anterior hip dislocation. Posterior dislocation is more common and it occurs in younger patients. It results from high energy impact like motor vehicle accident and dashboard on knees. The patient presents with shortening, flexion, adduction, and internal rotation of the affected limb. 10 to 20% of posterior hip dislocation are associated with sciatic nerve injury. There is a palpable femoral head and it is inferior to inguinal flexion crease. Extended periods with head dislocated predispose to osteonecrosis of femoral head. Now let us see about anterior hip dislocation. It is rare and it occurs while hip is extended and externally rotated. In this case, the patient presents with hip in flexion, abduction, and external rotation. Now let us see about the diagnosis of hip dislocation. Hip dislocation can be diagnosed using X-ray. Remember, in children, hip dislocation with spontaneous incomplete reduction can be missed by X-ray. This is because of incompletely ossified labrum interposed in joint space. Now let us see about the differential diagnosis of hip dislocation. We have to rule out associated acetabular fractures. This can be done by obtaining jutted films, which are 45 degree oblique views to see AP pelvic columns and acetabular wall. Proximal femoral fractures should also be ruled out in cases of hip dislocation. Now let us see about the treatment of hip dislocation. For anterior dislocation, we can do closed reduction if acetabular fracture is absent or minimal. The time between injury and reduction is important for long-term prognosis. Delay in treatment increases likelihood of osteonecrosis and post-traumatic arthritis. Anterior dislocation, if it has been successfully reduced, the patient can mobilize in days with full weight bearing by 4 to 6 weeks. Now let us see about the treatment of posterior dislocation. We have to apply traction in line of deformity. We have to rotate the hips internally and externally. Then we have to check stability and congruity of reduction. Open treatment can be done for open dislocations, for redislocation after reduction, and in cases of widened joint space with interposition of fragments or soft tissue. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. For more such videos, please check out my playlists. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.